And I'd like you to use commonswikimedia.org, remember that? Beginning tag, you need IMG. Do you see it on the chart over there?
This is not the kind of writing you might expect to see in the sixth grade language arts class at Hannah Ashton Middle School in Reynoldsburg.
It's instead of writing an explanatory essay, they're creating a website that is an explanatory essay, basically.
You should have three web pages, right? One paragraph on each page. A list on one of the pages, I don't care where, and an image on the main page.
In Renee Coley's Hidden Figures project, students are telling the stories of lesser-known African Americans who impacted history.
So this is just a practice bubble. It's going to teach you how to put your own image on your own website.
The students learn and create using code.org's web lab, one of many options for students in Ohio.
So it's an educational format to use to create a web page. So it has supports for them. It has step-by-step teaching them how to do that. I'm there as a support to walk them through those different lessons. And once they get a handle on it, they fly through it.
And then you like code it to see which one you got right. So then if you submit, you can see that it's correct.
Anybody can teach themselves how to code through code.org. It's a free curriculum. You log in. There are lessons that will walk you through it. That's how I learned it before I taught it. I did the lessons myself as a student. And I think that goes a long way to trying to understand HTML and CSS and JavaScript and all these things that sound so foreign, but it only takes a few lessons to think that's not so foreign, that's not so scary, it's not so intimidating.
And then we get to change the color of the paragraphs and stuff, and you get to use the CSS style sheet to use your creative thinking.
That's the name that has to go in your code, in between.
Students are learning the computer languages of HTML and CSS. So they're learning how to create not just the words on the page, but to style it, to make it look like a website. Background images, text, different fonts. They're also learning how to create a digital artifact, which is their website.
See, you got it to do it.
And they're learning digital citizenship. So knowing where to look for information and knowing how to share that information.
To go out and search, use one of those, see the commonswikipedia.org or .creativecommons. Use one of those websites. When you find an image, flag me down and I'll show you what to do.
It's way more easy than I thought. I thought it was going to be harder, but like it's not once you do it.
Students who finish early can move ahead to learn other skills, such as app development.
You've already done web lab, now you can learn this is JavaScript.
We can use computers to learn things kind of passively, but these students are not passively using their computers. They're using them to be creators, and I think that's where the power comes.
So this is my first year doing computer science. When I grow up, if I cannot be a cardiologist, I think I'll be a health IT information technician.
I like coding because it like helps me understand how to understand the processing. And while I was going through the process, it's like me getting a little smarter and smarter.